all computers have been using typewriter style keyboards as human input device. Due to layout of keys in a line Q, W, E, R, T, Y, they are also known as QWERTY style keyboards. Keyboards have been available in many designs. We will discuss keyboard keys, keyboard encoder, and keyboard controller used in IBM PC computer system. In last 35 years, there have been many types of keyboards used in successive models of IBM PC compatible computers, and we will study only a few types here. 1. Model F IBM PC XT keyboard. Figure 1 shows its image. It was a 83 keyboard having standard alphanumeric keys or buttons and was introduced in 1981. It had 10 function keys F1 to F10 grouped on left side. There was a separate keypad on right side. It served dual purpose. It offered numeric keys 0 to 9, which was considered as a great help to accountants who entered large numerical data. The numeric keypad could also be used as navigation keys for moving the cursor in up, down, left, and right direction. 2. Model F IBM PC 80 keyboard. Figure 2 shows its image. It was a 84 key keyboard introduced in 1984. It had additional key called SYSREQ or system request and 3 indicator LEDs. These two keyboards were not compatible due to differences in their internal controller design. 3. Standard layout keyboard. Figure 3 shows its image. It was a 101 key keyboard where the numeric keypad and navigation key clusters were separated. It was introduced in 1986, and since last 30 years, its design has remained more or less constant. There were many small improvements, and now it has 104 keys. We will now discuss its layout as shown in figure 4. The main cluster has following types of keys. 1. Alphabet keys. A to Z, common to be used in lower and upper case. 2. Numeral keys 0 to 9. 3. Special symbols such as exclamation mark, tilde, hash, caret, ampersand, and reverse slash. 4. Arithmetic symbols such as minus, plus, oblique, star, less than, greater than, percentage, dollar, parenthesis, and brackets. 5. Control keys. Escape, system request, print screen, pause, break, menu, win, scroll lock, etc. 6. Context keys. Number lock, shift, control, alt. 7. Punctuation symbols. Comma, full stop, semicolon, colon, single and double quotes, and dash. The top cluster contained escape and 12 function keys. On right side, there is a 4 key cluster for smaller cursor movement in X and Y direction, such as up down and left right by one row or one character position. Above that, there is a 6 key cluster to jump the cursor by larger movement, such as moving by a paragraph or a page. The cluster also contains edit keys for inserting and deleting operations. The rightmost part contains 12 key cluster, which houses 10 numerical digits, 4 arithmetic operators, number lock, and enter key. It was similar to a calculator and extremely convenient to enter huge tables of numerical data with minimal finger movement. Later improvements in this keyboard added several keys for music player control, sound control, or for putting PC in different modes. Some additional keys for internet browsing were also added. We will study two main types of keyboard interfaces and connectors here. IBM PC style keyboard. Initially, IBM PC used a 5-pin round DIN or DIN connector as shown in figure 5. The signals on various pins were pin 1 clock, pin 2 data, pin 3 reset, pin 4 ground, pin 5 plus 5 volts. This connector was male on keyboard and was plugged in matching female connector or jack provided on motherboard located in PC's system unit. The keyboard was powered up by 5 volt and ground through pins 4 and 5 supplied by PC up to a maximum of 275 milliampere current. Whenever PC needed, it could reset keyboard by sending a reset signal on pin 3. The key closure 8 bit or 16 bit code was converted into serial bit stream and sent over pin 2. The serialization clock was sent to PC on pin 1. IBM PS2 style keyboard. Later versions of IBM PC were called Personal Systems 2 or PS2, and its keyboard connector was called a PS2 style connector. It used 6 pins as shown in figure 6. The PS2 connector for keyboard and mouse interfaces were electrically similar and employed the same communication protocol. However, they were not interchangeable since the two devices used a different set of commands. 6. This connector has clock and data signals and 5 volt power connections. This connector is also used for mouse interface. Pin 2 and 6 here are not used on keyboard and hence can be used for mouse data and clock. PC 97 standard dictates that the keyboard jack on PC and male plugs must be purple colored and mouse jack and plugs must be green colored. USB style keyboard. Modern computers and laptops use USB interface and connectors to connect keyboard and mouse. The USB connector is called type A connector and shown in figure 7. It has 4 pins and signals on various pins are pin 1 plus 5 volt, pin 2 data minus, pin 3 data plus, pin 4 ground. It may be remembered that USB connectors and signals are standard for all peripherals, whether it is keyboard, mouse, serial port, or any other device. Keyboards are of two types, conductive type and capacitive type. Most of the inexpensive keyboards available in market use mechanical switches, which when pressed make contact between two wires. This causes the current to flow between the two contact points. When the switch is released, the current flow is interrupted. This is called as conductive type. The other keyboard senses the presence of finger on the surface through change of capacitance and hence known as capacitive type. In this module, we will focus on conductive type keyboard. Initially, the keyboard encoder was implemented using Intel's 8-bit microcontroller 8041 and 8042. Nowadays, more advanced microcontrollers are used which perform many more functions. All communication between the PC and the keyboard uses an IBM protocol which employs synchronous serial communication. Each keyboard has large number of mechanical keys. Each of these keys close two contact points provided on plastic flexible membranes put below. These contact points are arranged in a matrix form. An electronic controller called as keyboard encoder performs following tasks. 1. Poll or scan the status of matrix wires several times per second to detect which key or keys are pressed and which are in released state. 2. Wait for key to settle down after its transition. 3. Generate a one or more byte code and send it to PC serially. 4. Providing buffer of length 16 bytes to outgoing code. 5. Detecting that key is closed for long time and repeatedly generating same code automatically. 6. Setting options such as caps lock or num lock and scroll lock and show its status on LED indicators. 7. Perform internal diagnostics and report status to PC. 8. Obey commands received from PC. Figure 8 depicts keyboard encoder IC and LEDs on a printed circuit board inside a keyboard. IBM PC computer's motherboard contains an IC called as keyboard controller. It is a device that interfaces a keyboard to PC. It communicates with keyboard encoder and receives codes for key pressed and released in serial bit stream. It converts that into an 8-bit parallel form and passes it to main CPU. Its main function is to inform the computer when a key is pressed or released. When data from the keyboard arrives, the controller raises an interrupt signal to allow the CPU to handle the input. Controller also sends commands to encoder to turn on and off LEDs on the keyboard. In early days, IBM PC80 used an Intel 8042 chip to interface to the keyboard. Today, the keyboard controller is either a unit inside a Super I/O device or is missing, having its keyboard and mouse functions handled by a USB controller. The keyboard controller also handles PS2 mouse input if a PS2 mouse port is present. Figure 9 depicts keyboard controller 40-pin IC on old PC motherboard and 5-pin female jack connector on its right side. Now, we will study electrical interface between encoder and controller and their communication protocol. The main signals between encoder, keyboard side and controller, PC side are clock and data signals. These are open collector type and bidirectional. Mostly data is sent from keyboard to PC, but occasionally PC sends commands to keyboard on same set of wires. The signals on PC side controller are shown in figure 10. The keyboard encoder sends 8-bit code on data line. This is synchronized by a clock signal on clock line. The keyboard controller IC monitors clock line on input pin B, and whenever there is a valid transition, it captures bits from data line on its pin A. It assembles 8 bits and passes it on to main CPU. Whenever controller wishes encoder to wait, it asserts line C to one state, which in turn pulls down clock line to 0 state. Keyboard encoder then waits until clock line is released back to 1 state. This handshake ensures that data traffic from keyboard to PC is slowed down so that no codes are lost between two controllers. Whenever controller wishes to send command to keyboard, it sends its bitstream through pin D, which asserts it on data line. The communication protocol defines the frame for sending bytes. All data is transmitted one byte at a time, and each byte is sent in a frame consisting of 11 to 12 bits. These bits are 1 start bit, this is always logic 0, 8 data bits, least significant bit first, 1 parity bit, odd parity, 1 stop bit, this is always logic 1, one acknowledge bit only during PC to keyboard communication. Figure 11 depicts timing of sending one byte of code in terms of clock pulses and data bits. Note that after start bit, first bit to be sent is least significant or data 0 bit. Then data 1 bit to data 8 are sent. Next, parity bit is sent. In the end, stop bit is sent. Data sent from the keyboard to PC is read on the falling edge of the clock signal. Data sent from the PC to the keyboard is read on the rising edge. The clock frequency must be in the range 10 kilohertz to 16.7 kilohertz. The keyboard always generates the clock signal, but the PC always has ultimate control over communication. Keyboard encoder spends most of its time scanning or monitoring the matrix of keys. If it finds that any key is being pressed, released, or held down, then it sends a packet of information known as a scan code to the PC. There are two different types of scan codes, make code and break code. A make code is sent when the key is pressed or held down. A break code is sent when a key is released. Every key is assigned its unique make code and break code. So, the PC can determine exactly what is happening to which key by looking at the scan code. The set of make and break codes for every key comprises a scan code set. There are three standard scan code sets named 1, 2 and 3. All modern keyboards generate set 2 by default. Scan code set 1, original XT scan code set supported by modern keyboards. Scan code set 2, default scan code set for all modern keyboards. Scan code set 3, optional PS2 scan code set rarely used nowadays. For scan code set 1, whenever a key is pressed, an 8-bit code with most significant bit as 0 is generated and sent to PC. When the key is released, the same scan code is generated, but with MS bit as 1. For example, when key A is pressed, scan code 1E hex is sent. When A is released, scan code 91 hex is sent. In set 1, there are some keys which are represented by 2-byte scan code. In this case, the first byte is E0 hex. Thus, insert key in 6-key cluster when pressed will generate E0 hex followed by 52 hex. When the same key is released, it generates E0 hex followed by D2 hex. So, 52 hex has become D2 hex when key is released. In scan code set 2, the basic scan codes are 8 bit, but different than scan codes in set 1. When a key is released, its 8 bit scan code remains unchanged, but it is preceded by a byte F0 hex. When key A is pressed, scan code 1C hex is generated, but when it is released, scan code F0 hex followed by 1C hex is generated. Thus, in this set, press and release is not signaled by most significant bit, but by prefixing or not prefixing fixed code F0 hex before original scan code. In this set, some keys produce 2-byte or 16-bit code. For example, insert key produces 2-byte code E0 followed by 70. When this key is released, it will generate same 2-byte code preceded by F0, and thus 3 bytes sent will be F0, E0, 70, all hex bytes. The pause break key is a special key in the sense that it does not have a break code. in scan code sets 1 and 2. When this key is pressed, its make code is sent. When it is released, it does not send anything. Laptops use a special key called FN or function. This key is often used to modify the meaning of other keys. This FN does not produce scan codes itself. It only modifies the scan codes produced by other keys. It must be remembered that scan codes are defined specific to a physical key or a switch in a particular location, and their ASCII codes are decided later by keyboard controller or PC. Thus, the scan code of enter key in main cluster and enter key in numeric keypad will be different, but internally PC will generate same ASCII code for them and treat them identically. Scan code of A key will be same whether it is pressed for lowercase a or for uppercase A, and ASCII codes for both will be different. If you press a key, its make code is sent to the computer. But when you press and hold down a key, that key becomes typematic, which means the keyboard will keep sending that key's make code until the key is released or another key is pressed. To verify this, open a text editor such as MS Word and hold down the A key. When you first press the key, the character A immediately appears on your screen. After a short delay, another A will appear, followed by a whole stream of A's until you release the A key. There are two important parameters here: the typematic delay, which is a short delay between the first and second A, and the typematic rate, which is how many characters per second will appear on your screen after the typematic delay. The typematic delay can range from 0.25 seconds to 1 second, and the typematic rate can range from 2.0 CPS, that is characters per second, to 30.0 characters per second. You can change the typematic rate and the delay using the set typematic rate / delay 0xf3 command. Typematic data is not buffered within the keyboard. In the case where more than one key is held down, only the last key pressed becomes typematic. Typematic repeat stops when that key is released, even though other keys may be held down. To summarize, keyboard encoder IC inside keyboard detects key switch operation and sends a scan code to keyboard controller IC inside PC. The controller identifies the context and converts scan code into ASCII code and presents it to CPU.